Royals of Africa, Bolo, Bolo Animadia Royals. This is your queen, Antinigon, second of the name, 17th generation crown queen of the Fangs and of the diasporan Africans, also known as the Immortals. Welcome, welcome, my beautiful and amazing Royals of Africa. Welcome to Nubia, the path to return, the home of the African Royals. If you're watching me for the first time, hello, my name is Queen Ningon II and I'm the host here at Nubia, the Path to Return. If you like my vibe, stick around. I promise you, you will learn something. Now to my amazing and returning Royals of Africa, welcome back. If someone or something brings harm to you, our elders advise us to flee physically from it. We cut contact, communication, whatever, to flee mentally from them. We don't talk about them, we don't think about them, to flee spiritually away from them, to cut cords and call our energy back, call our power back, and stay on the clear, okay? Now, if they persist in persecuting you, sabotaging you, and seeking to destroy you in any way, we are also taught to fight back. And this is what this video is about. So in today's video, my dear Royals of Africa, I'm going to teach you not only how to survive the people around us who seek to take us out, not only that, but more importantly, how to defeat them once and for all, okay? So in today's video, I will share with you what I call my Royal Survival Guide, which is basically a summary of guidelines, my father's, meaning my dad, my grandfather, and my mother's, what they taught me to stay alive and defeat those who relentlessly come after me, okay? So let's jump in.
And this is a message that you have to listen to because this is a life or death situation. And when I post on here, I post things that can save someone's life. Majority of the time. Jealousy is real. And it's deadly. I've had women try to set me up to get trafficked before. The jealousy levels I've dealt with in the past, I'm lucky I'm still alive. I'm literally lucky I'm not dead. That's how bad it's been. And I'll tell you one thing, at this age, if I even get a small feeling that someone may be jealous towards me, I'm cutting you off. I do not care. I don't care if you're a male or female. If I feel like you are jealous of me, I don't care if you make a small joke, you're getting cut off. I'm not going to be Selena. I'm not going to be Shanquella Robinson. No. I'm so sorry. No. If I sense it, even if it's something, I don't even care if you're family. If I sense it or I catch you looking at me funny, you're getting cut off. I don't play with jealousy. I'll tolerate all types of stuff. I'll tolerate a flaky person. I'll tolerate a person that could have a little attitude sometime, but I'm not tolerating jealousy. Why? Jealousy is a murderous spirit. Cain and Abel, one of the first murders recorded in the Bible, was from the spirit of jealousy on Cain's end. I'm not tolerating it. I've cut off so many family members off of that crap. I want you out of my life and out of my presence immediately. You will never walk in a room with me. You'll never see me face to face ever again. That is how I feel. I feel very strongly about jealousy. because it drives people to kill. It drives people to kill. People will go to a freaking pawn shop and purchase a gun and start driving down your neighborhood to shoot you for whatsoever reason. That's how people are. These women out here, I don't deal with women, honestly. You have to be a certain type of woman. I'm not a girl's girl. I don't go into rooms. I don't have big friend groups. I don't trust women. That's just not me. You have to be a certain type of woman for me to deal with you, because I know how, I think women are very insidious and evil in nature. I think women are very vindictive and just dark energy. That's just what I think. And I don't want to deal with them. Unless necessary, I don't want to deal with them. I don't care. I don't need big friend groups. I don't need a chick calling me every day. I do low maintenance friendships. We can talk here and there, but I'd rather us not talk at all. I don't need it. I don't. And I just don't feel like it's necessary. But yes, be careful with jealousy. It's serious. It's out there. It's in your family. It's at your job. It's at your church, your friend group. Your man may be laying next to you and he's jealous of you. Men are jealous of women too. That's also a thing. So watch your back.
Melanated dominant people, sons and daughters of my ancient mother. This season, you can no longer hang out with jealous people. You cannot hang out with your haters, okay? I know that young people, that gives you a clout, right? They just hating on me. They hating on me. No. Let me tell you what my grandmother used to say. That jealousy is as cruel as a grave, and a jealous person to kill you. And all of that is true, baby. They have glamorized having haters. But no, this next season, when Pluto returns in 2024, right? She is the planet of karma. She is coming to bring to you all of those good seeds. How you done took care of people that done talked about you like a dog, all right? You done gave to people that wouldn't even piss on you if your ass was on fire, okay? All those good seeds. This is the season, right? This is the shift. The shift of the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the righteous. This is the big shift, right? But at the same token, that it's a big shift for you, a blessing for you. These people, the jealous, hateful, narcissistic, using, manipulative, getting over on people, okay? They are finna reap hell, okay? And just think, they're gonna be reaping hell at the same token as the person that they have done so wrong is reaping heaven. You cannot have these people in your life. You can't have jealous people in your life. Baby, let me tell you something. If they follow you on TikTok, they know you in real life. Follow you on TikTok, but don't like your videos. Don't comment on it. Don't share them. Leave them alone. They jealous. They're jealous. If they can't give you a flat out compliment, let me tell you how jealous people give you a compliment. They'll say, oh, I like that sweater, but they'll never say you pretty. Okay? They'll never say you pretty because they can't. They will hurry up and have something to do when you telling them some good news, but get popcorn and a soda when it's time for you to tell them something bad going on in your life. Get rid of these people. Get rid of them. Get rid of them. Get rid of them. I don't care if it's your mama. Get rid of them. I don't care if it's your daughter. Get rid of them. It is time to get rid of jealous, unsupported, hateful people. Why? Because when hell come for them, baby, heaven come from you, they'll kill you. They will. Now, and I'm not talking about killing your physical body, that too, but kill your joy, right? They will be there to keep you anchored down so you can't be as happy, right, as you ought to be at this time, right? It is time to get rid of them. I know it's this whole little thing, keep you some haters. No, not in this season. Haters had a time period. The narcissistic, manipulative, low down, using people, they had a time period. The great mother allowed them to see your love and your kindness and to see you be blessed in hopes, right, that they will be like, you know what? I need to change my ways if I want things to work out for me. And they made the decision and stood flat-footed
to be hateful, deceitful, manipulative, jealous, all of that, right? And now they cannot go back on their decision. The decision has been made. Just like you passed the test, they failed the test. In this next season, in 2024, when Pluto returns, get rid of them. 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 They're going to steal your joy. They're going to drain your joy. They're going to drain your resources, right? And your blessed season is going to look like your struggle season because you done took your enemy with you, okay? I'm here to tell you, if the Great Mother hasn't already separated you, right? Then it's time for you to separate. It's time for you to separate. You can't have jealous people in your life. If you don't have people in your life that has on pom-poms, right? Got pom-poms and a cheerleader outfit on, cheering you on, right? The days of being unequally yoked is over, right? If you are making $100,000, you can't run with the girl that's making $8 an hour. I'm sorry, you can't. Why? Because that season of us trying to save them, right? Help them. People don't need your help, baby. Let me tell you something. They don't need your help. Why? Because they don't want help. They are addicted to the attention that they are getting from the suffering. They don't want your help. They'll say they want your help. And all they're going to do is drain your resources. And after you get through with all of that, them draining your resources, guess what happens? They still in the same place they was before. They're going to talk about you like a dog and move on to the next leash. Those days are over. I know you've been trying to show them like, look, you know, because I'm so loving and kind, God bless me. No. No. So are we clear on that? Every hater in your life, leave them alone. And even them haters that they in your family, when I say don't even be alone with them in the room, okay? Feed them with a long handle spoon. You understand me? If they don't call you, don't call them, okay? The days of hanging out with people that are jealous and hateful is over. This is your season to be blessed. Don't let them drag you down. I love you, Melanated Dominant People, and you have a good day.
Okay, before we start, I would like to drop a quick disclaimer. Of course, this teaching is solely for my African people. Okay, my forefathers and foremothers' stolen children. This teaching applies to them. Why? Because we have the same spiritual composition. We have the same ancestries. The decree pronounced over our ancestors are the same. So it only applies to them. Don't act all shocked if you hear something that is completely foreign to you, and it's okay. You can sit there and learn, okay? Let's jump in. My dear people, when you see such testimony, of course, they bring your vibe down. You know, many of us who have been constantly under attack, and as you know, the attack never comes from strangers. Never. The attacks always come from people you allowed around you, from people you call your friends, from people you call your besties, from people you even took for brothers and sisters. These are the ones who would come against you, okay? So you have to understand that we wrestle not like the holy book says, we wrestle not with flesh, we wrestle not with the pack of flesh, that individual, no. We are wrestling with the principality, the entity that have taken possession over them. Because that duality, light versus dark, it's something of creation, okay? You have to understand that light and darkness are both part of the creation. They go together. We came from darkness before we emerged into the light. So both of them are good. None of them is bad. The problem is, many of us have a hard time maintaining a balance, not to be too much in the light, because when you are just strictly in the light, I mean, come on, the dark, you drive them crazy. All you're gonna do is be on the defensive, you know, battling idiot. So it's also necessary for the children on Zambay to know how to tap into the dark. Go and visit the dark, kick some behind, and come back into the right middle. So light and dark are welcome for Nzambe, okay? For those of you who really carry the light of God, the light of Nzambe, you will notice that you often attract people under spiritual darkness, all right? And that's a fact. You probably wonder why each time I want to make friends, it's always the worst person that comes around. In the beginning, they're nice and then they change and blah, blah, blah. You have to understand things at a spiritual level for it all to make sense. For those of you who really carry the light of God, often, you would notice that you attract people under spiritual darkness. And that's a fact. That's just a fact. Okay? Even in couples, you will see sometimes, most couples, there's one who's clearly in the light, but they match to a demon. You even wonder what they're doing together. That's how it goes, okay? Because when they met, they were not spiritually awakened. At least the person who carries the light was not even aware of who he is or who she is. So they took someone they should have taught something as a spouse, and now they're stuck and the battle is going on. Okay? So why is that, you probably wonder? Because it has been naturally and scientifically proven that darkness is always attracted to light. Okay? It's just the fact. You know, when you wear dark color clothes, what happens? You start feeling hot because you're attracting more light. This is how it works. Just like we are taught in physics, the negative pole must always be matched to the positive pole of any device for it to work. When you put batteries into a device, you must match the negative pole of the battery to the positive pole of the device charger for the device to work. We all know that. That's exactly what happens spiritually. When your light shines bright, you will attract many people under spiritual darkness. Now, depending on the intensity of your light, depending on how bright your light is in the spirit realm, and depending on how deep in the light of God you are, you will attract people who are similarly intense in darkness. What do I mean by that? Okay, let's just say your light intensity or strength is at a positive 100 and somebody around you, darkness intensity is at a negative 100. Trust and believe that that person who's at a negative 100 will be attracted to your positive 100 light intensity, just like a moth to a flame. That's what it is. I'm basically just giving you a scientific aperçu or breakdown, because many people think that there is no God in science, and that's one of the biggest lies we were told. Nzambe is everywhere in science. Nzambe uses science to explain the process of things to us. Nzambe uses science to break it down to us. That's all. That's what we are taught, okay? Nzambe is everywhere in science. That's why we call him the only what? Omniscient, the all-knowing one. And when you see omniscient, omniscient is derived from omniscience. In omniscience, you find science, okay? So omniscience is the state of knowing everything, the state of knowing it all, and such in Nzambe. So you have to understand that our spirituality, you know, can be explained through science, because Nzambe is everywhere in science. So my dear people, before we get aggravated about the kind of people our light brings around us, we have to understand the depth of things. Okay, let's continue. So in short, as a light bearer, you will attract many people under spiritual darkness, and that's a fact. Now, it may sound a little discouraging to even want to bear the light, but please do not be discouraged, because there are far greater spiritual benefits and reward in being chosen to bear the light and heal the darkness than there is in being of service to the darkness. And I will tell you more about it later, but first, you have to understand the war at hand. You have to understand the principalities, the entities. The children of Tata Nzambe are still battling until today. So previously we have established that it is darkness which is attracted to the light, and it's never the other way around. When the dark sees the light, it follows it. When you are in a pitch dark room or road, and then you see a glimpse of light, you are going to follow it. So the same happens when it comes to people's interaction. People who are under spiritual darkness will naturally be attracted to light bearers. And some of them may even grow obsessed over time with the light bearer's energy. Okay? So know that when you encounter people under spiritual darkness, the intensity of your light will always be a match to the intensity of their darkness. Now, do you think it's a mere coincidence? Why do you think is it so? Let me tell you something, my beautiful people. No, it's not. It is because you were chosen to counter their darkness. That's why Tatan Zambe even allow you guys to meet. So Tatan Zambe gave them access to you because the intensity of your light can counter their darkness. That's the reason why. Zambe is not going to choose someone with a lesser light intensity to deal with an individual with a higher darkness intensity. The light bearer wouldn't otherwise be able to counter such darkness. So it's understood. So to ensure victory over that darkness, over such darkness, Zambe would give them access only to his warriors with the matching light intensity. What do I mean by that? It means that you can defeat, retire, or archive anyone who chooses to fight you in any way because you are their match. So fear not. Spiritually, you are like their kryptonite, okay? So bring them down if that's what you need to do to continue on your path and purpose in life. But first, it is crucial that you can identify people under spiritual darkness and then run a thorough spiritual diagnostic on them. Only then do you stand a chance encountering them, healing them, or forcing them to retire from their demonic activities. Okay? Batatas, bananas. The first thing you must understand about people under spiritual darkness is that they are usually victims of abuse and trauma themselves, resulting in traumatized individuals who are yet to heal from their current or past traumas, and because of which they carry the spirit of fear heavy. You know, our elders warn us against the spirit of fear. Our elders teach us that fear is the doorway to hell. When a man starts fearing something, he opens a doorway to fear-mongering spirit to have access to him or her and start controlling him. So demonic spirit use fear to control people. Therefore, when you see an individual carrying so much fear in them about anything, just know that he's a prime candidate for demonic spirit to catch him, for demonic spirit to possess him, and for demonic spirit to control him, okay? Our elders also teach us that people become spiritually dark when they harbor unforgiveness, which comes from the trauma and abuse which they have endured. The spirit of unforgiveness works just like the spirit of fear. The spirit of unforgiveness will open up a door to welcome hatred and vengeance mongering spirit to come influence you and eventually possess you whole. Look at people who are spiritually dark as victims themselves to begin with. They are whose victim? They are the devil's victim. They are the darkness victim. Because as you know, the devil doesn't have any children because the devil never created any life, never created anything. All life belongs to Zambe. It's us who make a choice to follow the path of the darkness or stay in the light with Tata Zambe. So you have to look at them as the slave of the devil, slave of the darkness. They are the devil's prisoner. The devil doesn't have any children. He got prisoners, victims, and slaves. Okay?
Cash money records taking over for the 99 and the 2000. Girl, you want to go back in. You back in. Make it work with the cash in. It's last year. Girl, smile when you pass in. In that day, you can ride in a jacket. With that day, you can smoke by your bag in. Aggression. Got money like a flash in. A
I'm a bitch, I'm a player, yeah. Gun spray, yeah. A clear head, a flipper, yeah. Great feeling, yeah. Like I be slinging wood, yeah. I'm out of hood, yeah. That ain't the understood, yeah. It's all good, yeah. Got a gun, see me long, yeah. On the hard, yeah. Smoke me with a broad, yeah. I'm on the strong, yeah. If you can do a trick, yeah. On the stick, yeah. You tell me you want a bitch, yeah. It ain't it.
What can happen to a man or a woman's life once they let this spirit in them? Like, for example, the spirit of fear. Fear can lead you to do crazy things, just fear-based. Like, for example, you found, for example, a thief, someone who has stolen something or was caught stealing. Now he's afraid to be exposed or identified. What does he do? He pulls his weapon and alive the witness. So now from a theft case, we now have a murder case, all that motivated by fear. If he wasn't afraid of being exposed or being caught, if he went by the understanding that, okay, I measure all my risk, what I'm about to do, if I get caught, I'm gonna face the justice of the land or whatever. If they go in there with that mindset, they won't analyze anybody. But they go in there already, they're not themselves, because the fear of exposure has opened up the door for demonic spirit to come and whisper nonsense to their ear. Oh, such and such saw you, you must silence them. Such and such know, you must take them out, and so, fear, okay? You will see, for example, another thing that fear would do in the lives of people. People will lose self-esteem, they will resolve in all kinds of manipulation. All kinds, including spiritual manipulation, for fear of being rejected. So for that reason, growing up, my father and especially my grandfather used to have me repeat, I am Mingon, I fear no one. Me and my sibling, we were asked to say our name and say we fear no one. So this is how our parents started conditioning our mind to conquer fear from a young age. So we can never entertain it. So even today, start conditioning your spirit with such affirmation. I am so and so, I fear no one. Say it with assurance, say it with clarity. I am so and so, I fear no one, I fear nothing. So this is a good conditioning, because a person who fear no one or nothing can easily cut people off, places and things will no longer serve them. They can walk away at any time. Okay, they're not afraid to find themselves alone. They have a deep understanding about their spirituality, and they understand that every rejection is God's protection. So when something doesn't go as planned, maybe, they understand that Zambe is trying to maybe protect them from something, and they take a step back. Instead of viewing a rejection like, oh, Zambe, what have I done, blah, blah. They say, okay, wait a minute, Zambe, what are you trying to protect me from? Okay? And of course, any question you ask to Zambe, he will answer you. He will answer you. He will deliver the answer to you through meditation, through a dream, through clairaudience, through a song, through whatever. But Zambe will never leave you hanging. Know that the light that you carry was God-given. It's nothing that you did on your own or went and purchased it or went and manipulated some entity to have. No, it was given to you due to the purity of your heart. Okay? Number one, you have to know what is the light that you carry. The light that you carry is your ability to love unconditionally, is your ability to forgive, is your ability to remain pure in thoughts, actions, and intention. The light that you carry is your ability to stand for justice, even when it's unpopular. The light that you carry is your ability to help the weak and elevate the weak and the poor. Your ability to comfort those in crisis. All that constitute your light. These are abilities that most people are not born with. But Zambe gave you a heart that is beautiful, that can host his light. So take pride. If you don't feel attracted by evil, if you find yourself bored around toxic people, don't feel down, don't feel sad. Feel yourself chosen, feel yourself special. Thank God for giving you the heart you have. Thank God for not allowing you to be born with a heart that can easily be attracted by darkness, by wickedness, by causing harm and pain to people. So it's a grace and it's all to be born with such heart. So give praise to Zambe, give thanks to Zambe. All these gifts and characteristics were given to you by Tata Zambe, and no one can take them away from you, no matter how hard they try. The only way you can lose your light is if you surrender it to the people of darkness. Like you hook up with a demonic guy and gradually he turns you dark. You hook up with a demonic girl, a very mean spiritual, evil, jealous. And gradually she turned you as mean, spiritual, evil, jealous as her. This is the only time you can lose your light. But when you stand firm in your unconditional loving ability, when you remain pure in your thought, actions, and intention, when you stand for justice no matter what, when you are there to help the weak and the poor and elevate them and comfort those in crisis, your light is beaming bright, because that's what Zambe wants us to do. Zambe wants us to spread that light in such a dark world. So you're in good standing with Zambe. And what does it mean when you're in good standing with Zambe? Anything you want, anything you ask for, Zambe shall grant it to you, my children. That's what we are taught. So let's jump into the heart of the topic. So as you grow spiritually, you will learn to identify such energies, meaning individuals who are spiritually dark. You know, you will learn to identify them. Not only that, you also will learn how to engage them at the level at which they need to be engaged. Because with spiritual maturity, we learn a lot of things. We learn limit. We set boundaries with such entities. The minute we see, we don't give that much of a benefit of the doubt. We learn to listen to our spirit guides. Our spirit guide would always tell us, it's like we say, oh, something, no. Your spirit guide. Many of you who are royal children, descendants of the slain kings. Back in the days, anywhere you see a royal child, you saw them with their entourage. They usually had their maids with them and they had their security. Same thing in the spirit. We don't walk alone. We have entourage. So there's always going to be a guide that will tell you, the person you're talking to, these are their intention, and so on and so on. With spiritual maturity, you are going to learn to listen to that guidance. You are going to learn to quiet your mind. You are going to learn to discern which message comes from your spiritual team and which other message might be a projection from the enemy into your mind. You know, they are able to do that through a method of inception. They incept an idea, a seed in your brain, and all of a sudden you start feeling afraid and stuff. No, it came from somewhere. They projected it to you. With spiritual maturity, you learn how to navigate through life. You know who to bring close enough to become a partner, a boyfriend, and eventually a fiancé and husband. And you know who to keep away. You learn not to create soul ties with spiritually dark individuals. You learn that they are not marriage material, they are here. They can never make close friends, keep them at arm's reach as an associate or acquaintance. They can never make a business partner because, hey, if they dwell in the dark and you dwell in the light, you guys gonna clash. If they haven't gone through anything in life that will force them to seek the light, trust and believe, they're gonna try to bring you down until Zambe humbles them. So while you're dealing with them, you make sure you don't bring them in their bloodline, because it becomes more difficult when you have a child with such entities. Now the devil is in your family. You learn all that, you learn how to navigate through all that fogginess. So you learn to keep them at arm reach, at bay, like they say. We first must teach them the ways of Zambe. We must declare to them on which side of the spectrum we stand. We have to let them know I'm one of Zambi. I'm a child of Zambi. I dwell in the light. I don't do the gossip. I don't do the backstabbing. I don't do the disloyalty for no reason. I don't do the grouping on one. I don't do none of that. Be vocal about it. You may lose so-called friends, but that's what it is to be a warrior from Zambi. The dark and the light, when they meet, the light must brighten the dark, or there's no match. You have to call it off. You have to send them off away from you, okay? We must clearly declare to them on which side of the spectrum we stand, which is the side of the light, before they try to destroy you. Because yes, they will. Our elders teach us that when darkness meets the light, a battle takes place. One will win over the other. That's what happened. So when these entities are attracted to you on a mission, the minute you have identified them as such, tell them who you are, what you stand for, and if they want to follow you in the light, if they don't, get rid of them. Okay? Get rid of them. Don't blink. Get rid of them, because one will always win over the other. Either they convert you or they turn you into a slave where they tap into your energy, because you have to understand the world in which we live in. Now that with this awakening and the internet, there's knowledge that is being thrown left and right. Since the captivity of our people, the fall of our people, they destroy our spirituality and replace it with religion and secret societies. And those of our people who are in the secret society, we know what they do there. These are witch and warlock covens. They put such knowledge in the hand of unhealed people. What do you think is going to happen there? They're going to use it to destroy each other. So you have to understand what we're dealing with. So each time darkness meets the light, a battle takes place. They will either try to convert you into a dark entity like themselves, or they will seek to destroy you, using you as using your light as a battery, as a charge. Now those who are skilled into it, if you don't know how to protect yourself and you open your heart chakra, because that's where they get you, when you have an open heart to them. We will cover that later, how to block them. Because they can only run from you when you love them. But when you're on guard, you see them for who they are. You tell your team that no matter what, even if you hear me talk to such an individual, I don't trust them. On guard, 24/7, they won't be able to suck you dry. So you have to make sure of that. Because our elder tells us that one will win over the other. That's why our elders tells us to be very choosy of who we allow around us, who we allow in our energy, because many spiritually dark individuals just want to get to you close enough in order for them to dehumanize you or demonize you, because your light irritates their demon. So they're on the mission. When they come around you, they come on a mission to put out your light. They're not interested about being like you. They're not interested about learning anything to bring that level of brightness or shine to them. No, they're solely there to put out your light. They have sold their soul to the darkness. Many of them are 3-4 generations deep into Masonry or Eastern Star, whatever they call it, which are really warlocks and witches coven. When the masters gave us access to such knowledge, which they stole from our ancient Egyptian ancestors. So they put it at available at exchange of their soul. So that's how they catch the elite among us. And our people know not everybody should have access to knowledge. That's why such knowledge was available only to people judged fit to become initiated. So what they do, oh, you have a master degree, you have a PhD, oh, you're part of the elite, automatically they enroll them into these things. But the masters, they have been knowing what they're doing, because when they give access to such knowledge to us, they knew that putting such knowledge in the hands of traumatized and unhealed individuals, what are they going to do? They will destroy each other with it. Just like when they drop drugs and guns into our neighborhoods, our cities and countries. What do they think we're gonna do with it? Destroy ourselves with it. So it's the same thing. Now that you have a clear understanding of who you are as the one in Zambi, a child of Zambi, let's move on to the next part of our message. How do we survive spiritually dark individuals, and how do we defeat them once and for all?
It is the application, not the knowledge, that the truth becomes a part of you. May you please bow your heads. I pledge allegiance to my ancestors, my people, and Africa, Iguzuba, the Empire of the Sun. I ask in your favor, may the ancestors locate you. We are Amandla. Amesu. Togoza bogogo na bonkulu. Zamaku.